giving honor to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. To Reverend Willie C. Bonds, the great pastor of this church, Mrs. Bonds, my sister in Christ. To Reverend Bracy, my brother in the Lord, and Mrs. Bracy, and to all the ministers in the house of God. God bless you all for being here today. It is hard to follow, they said on the school board, they don't like following me because it gets a level higher. But it's hard to come after all the ministers without an ordination. But there's an anointing, so I'll take the anointing. I want to say to you about Congresswoman Corrine Brown. I know how to stay in my lane. You're not going to find me running all over to this, that, and this. Education is my lane. And we have done it well. The sales tax that you saw that happened would not have happened had Corrine Brown not pushed it and was the first elected official to come on board to say, go with it and let it ride under the leadership of Ronald Blocker and the school board. I want you to know that the first scholarships that were given in Orange County, we held it many, many years at the school board. There were over 3,000 students that showed up at that school board, and the fire marshal had to close it down. And Corrine Brown and her staff, they were running around trying to figure out how can we serve all of these students. And we want you to know we've already sent a letter letting them know what she's done. In DeVry, when the Haitian community grew in School Board District 5, it was Corrine Brown that says, we're going in and we're going to tutor. And we got with Ron, we got with Dr. James Lawson, and they did not want to come to the school board. They wanted to meet right in their neighborhoods. And we went right into the different villages. And Corrine supplied computers for every one of those families. You can give that a round of applause. Every family, every child received that computer. I want you to say I've had the opportunity to work with Corrine when I first got to Orlando, Florida. And not only that, when she was first elected as a legislator out of Jacksonville, I was sent by Royce Walden and the school board, Harriet Merhill and Billy Henry. And we went to Tallahassee during the entire time. And Corrine saw us. She didn't know us. She said, come here, where are you all from? And we said, Orlando. She said, look, I'm going to introduce you to some legislators. These are the people you need to know. And from that day forward, we met Carrie, we met Gerardo, we met Cope. There were so many of the black legislators that we met under her leadership, because she saw a need. She said, I'm going to make education one of my main priorities. And I'm talking about this was when she first got in the State House of Florida. She worked that thing. And then she decided in the 90s that she would move on. But she would call us and say, look, I want you in Tallahassee. I want you up here. Reginald will be there running us around with Greenberg and Troy when he was working there. But Corrine was the one that set the agenda for us. We never had to put our agenda together when we got to Tallahassee, because we knew what room we were going in, how we were going, and what we were going to accomplish, and what bill was going to be passed. We didn't make a big deal about it because it was all done under her leadership. She took that leadership to Congress. She said, I want you in Tallahassee to move on to the Congress. When I go to Washington, I want you in Washington. You are not going to be visiting any Democrats. You're going in to the Republican's office. I got your Democrats covered. I said, oh my God, don't take me in there. She said, call Chet, call Ronita, call my office, and I want you to get your schedule, because when you get here, you're going to have your schedule. When we got to Washington, every year, including this year, our schedule was always set. So the least I could do was buy the lunch for her staff. I didn't have to do anything but walk in, and we were in the Senate. I had the opportunity of sitting. My brother's a train engineer, and I'm sitting in there when she was chairing the transportation and all the lawsuits were going on with all the train wrecks, and she was handling that day. I called my brother, I said, turn on CNN. Pouring is wide open. Wide open, baby, I'll tell you. And it was so many different things that I've had to experience in Washington with her. I've never left her side. I didn't have to bring any money tonight, because the minute I heard about Corrine, she will tell you she got a check. I said, well, who do you want me to give it to Rachel? She got her check. Then when we heard about something else, she got her check. When she heard about this tonight, she got her check, and guess what? She'll get another check. Not only that, I'm going to help as much as I can. Jackson, I'm going to help because you're just awesome in what you do. But let me tell everyone in here tonight, God knows the plan that he has for all of us. And what God has for us, nobody can take it away. Nobody will be able to take what you have done. Now let me tell you how hard Corrine fought. Corrine fought hard to keep our district. Why? Because we had black people. We had black people in the state of Florida going as delegates. That won't happen this time. Ms. Bracey and I had to debate how we were going to get to go to Washington to be a delegate to help get the president and the party nominated. One of us had to drop out because that's what she was fighting for. You won't have that no more. When we ran before, there were two women and one man. When we ran this time, it was one woman and two men. That's what she was fighting against. See, people don't understand that. So when Bracey went in, I went on another level. I went on the state level, which is harder to do, which is much harder to do with the help of Corrine and Reginald. I was able to go in two or three times and serve. And with the Obama and the Hillary and the Obama. All right? So I'm here to let you know, this is what she was trying to say. Don't tear up Sanford. Don't tear up Gainesville. Don't tear up Orlando. But people could not see it. See, that's the way the people were in the Bible.